Batman must once more save Gotham from a who's who medley of his worst enemies, including a mysterious new villain dubbed the Arkham Knight. Confession. I don't like superheroes. Watchmen author Alan Moore once suggested their existence in American culture might have something to do with a kind of an ingrained American reluctance to engage in confrontation without massive tactical superiority. Nonetheless, superheroes are now pretty much ubiquitous in our entertainment, and I submit that at some point we're going to have to grapple with some of the less pleasant particulars of why that's the case. But it's also testament to how well the Arkham games work that the idea of playing a protagonist as sadistic, pretentious, and at times borderline sociopathic as Batman doesn't really factor when the game plays this well. And if you are a Batman fan, all the better for you. Arkham Knight, which sees Batman square off against old enemies in one new, the eponymous and identity unknown Arkham Knight, in a vast open world playground, is developer Rocksteady at the top of its game, expressing a masterful, anted-up understanding of how and why its series finally broke gaming's awful superhero tie-in curse half a decade ago. Here's the stuff I liked. Is the Joker really dead? I was prepared, upon Arkham Knight's announcement years ago, to toss it in the trash if it turned out the Joker's demise in the last game was just an emotional exploit intended all along to preface another soap opera worthy resuscitation. Hey, just because the corporate comics do it doesn't mean games can't take the higher ground. But no, Rocksteady went and okay, I can't confirm that the Joker is or isn't in Arkham Knight. That would be telling. But I can tell you this, Rocksteady manages to get you thinking about the question in the cleverest possible way. In fact, I'd argue it's the narrative component in the game that's pulled off best.